Hello and welcome, guys. It is ThatSrb2DUDE here today, bringing you a Q&A. It's been about 4 weeks or a month, and I'm finally doing it. Yeah, I'm terrible, aren't I? Anyways, I'm going to start this Q&A. I'm going to be as quick as possible, or not too quick, I should say, because there are a ton of questions, probably over 100, and I did say I was going to answer all of them, because I'm just such a nice guy, aren't I? Okay, I'm joking, anyway. Let's get on to the Q&A. So first, I did say post on Twitter and YouTube. Reason why I said on Twitter, because, well, I didn't tell you this, but Twitter has priority. So I'm going to answer all my Twitter questions first and then go on to my YouTube. So without further ado, again, let's get into the Q&A. So our first question comes from Justin Lemony, and he says, what post will questions be asked for Q&A? And I'm guessing he means, when am I going to answer the questions? Well, today, in this video, that's when I'm asking them. So, the next question was from Kite at Genga the Scrub. And he asks, besides Splatoon, what is your favorite game? Now, I would have to say one of my favorite games right now that I'm playing, I've been playing a lot, is Overwatch. It's a new game that's being created by Blizzard. I was actually one of the lucky few that got in the closed beta. Yep, I didn't tell anyone, but I'm there. So that's probably my favorite game right now. Lameme Team says, how can mirrors be real if our eyes aren't? And the thing is about that is that mirrors are real because we can see them, and that will mean our eyes are real even though they're not. TicTacs39 says, did you join Spades? And yes, I did, back in the day. When I was in clubs, I joined Spades. And now it turned into Bittersweet GG. And now it's Team Paradise. Atom Beckett says, why do I use the custom Rapid Blaster Pro over the regular one? The reason why I use it is that it has Disruptor, and pretty much in any close range situation, you can just throw a Disruptor, you run away or back off, then you kill the person, and you can do that with pretty much every single kill if you wanted to. You can do it with long range. You can like put some bomb range onto for your Disruptor and then just throw them at range, and then you just attack people from range because that's what the Rapid Blaster Pro has. So that's pretty much why I use it over that. Lulink says, for the Q&A, point sensors or Disruptor? I would say Disruptor because there is literally no counter to it unless you have, unless you super jump out of it. Nymphia1 says, love all your Splatoon content. My question is, how can I play a Dynamo as a support role, and what is the best gear setup for it? Now, to be honest, I don't usually use Dynamos that much. Like, I barely even use it. But the gear that I would normally run on the Dynamo is Stealth Jump, Quick Respawn, and Ink Saver main, I would say. Like, I'm not too great with Dynamo. I mean, I don't really know what to do with it anyway. So, that's what I would run, and I hope it helps out if you try to get some sort of build for that. John at Surf and Scraddle says, people say that motion controls is better than sticks controls. As a stick player, is there any benefits for using sticks over motion controls? And I can tell you that there isn't really, because literally you can do everything on motion controls that you can do in sticks. And you have an advantage of just, movement and just how many things you can do in one movement besides in sticks. Because with sticks, you have to put like 20 different inputs to do one thing, where in motion control, you can just slightly move your controller to the left and it'll do the exact same things. So, yeah, that's my thoughts of it. QuivoKid17 at QuivoKid asked, will you ever incorporate facecam in your videos and live streams? P.S. Keep up the good work. Thank you very much. I've had a couple facecams on my live streams, not for like the entire one, like probably like a minute or so. I don't normally have facecams, mainly because it's just like the angle's kind of weird. Plus my lighting in my room is terrible. The angle, though, is just like you see the side of my ear, and that's pretty much it. And the lighting is that you can't really see. Well, it's not the clearest picture. Like, I don't have any lighting equipment to actually help that. Izzy at Mrs. Elf asked two questions. She asked first, what weapon is the most challenging for you to use? I'd say the Hydra Splatling, and probably one of my most favorite weapons, as you can see in this video that's in the background right here. And she also asks, if you had the chance to create your own brand new weapon type for Splatoon, what would it be? Now, I'm trying to think because it's really hard to actually think of like what type of new weapon type that could be. But I would have to say maybe a flamethrower or something like that. Like it would be, instead of like a flamethrower, it would be like spray paint or something like that. Like that would probably be, I don't know. That's the only one I could possibly think of, but yeah. Benox at CF Benox asked, when I started playing Splatoon, did I think that I'd become this big? And to be honest, of course, no. I don't really expect things like this to happen. Like it just, well, in August, I guess, it just kind of, my channel just started to take off. People started noticing me. I'm pretty sure it's mainly because a lot of people started posting my stuff on Reddit. And I was just like, why are you guys doing this? But yeah, that's pretty much why that happened, and of course I did not expect this to happen. Like, we're at 10,000 subscribers, this is crazy. Candace at Talented Cook asked, for the Q&A, have you played The World's End With You or Deadly Pro Nomination? Both are two of my favorite games. I have not played either of these games, Candace, so I'll have a look at them. Definitely, this is what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to Google them and see what's up. Nick Vega at Epic Nux asks, are there any other games that you played competitively before Splatoon? Mine was Mario Kart Wii. Keep up the great work and stay fresh. Thank you very much, Nick. And there was this one game that I did play competitively. It was technically a fan game. It was called Ace of Spades. It was like a Vox shooter. And the community there was most cancerous community I've ever like looked upon. It was that bad. But for some reason, I was just like, you know what? Let's play this game competitively. I'm going to find a team and then I'm going to play against some people. And unfortunately, I was called a hacker. And then many people didn't really like me, even though I didn't. Because that's hacking in the game is just completely stupid. Why would you let a game play for you? I don't understand. But then I started making some Ace of Spades montages, and then people started seeing that, and they were just like, oh my god, this guy's actually good. So, yeah, that was my other competitive game that I did play competitively. Competitive, saying it for 20 million times in one sentence. But, yeah, that was it. So those were the questions that were asked to me on Twitter, and I thank thee for asking them, and I don't know why I just said thee there, so... Anyways, let's just go into the YouTube comments. Brandon Roby asks, have I ever thought about expanding my channel to games like Mario Maker and Smash? And I have been thinking about expanding my channel with other games. I've been also thinking about doing like a little Star Fox series, like up, well, to the lead up of Star Fox Zero, because I'm somewhat looking forward to that game. If it's like a multiplayer game like Smash, I would like to have a little bit of knowledge about it, or just be generally good at the game, because I'm just okay at Smash. I'm not even that great. I play it casually. So, Jeffy asked, "Will you 1v1 me? Octoshot kills only." No. Jeffrey asks, "What is your favorite Sonic game/games?" And I would have to say Sonic. Well, actually, not Sonic. Shadow the Hedgehog was my favorite Sonic game of all time. And I guess Sonic Adventure 2, the Adventure series, the Advance series was probably... Actually, no. It starts with Sonic Adventure... Wait, no. It starts with Shadow the Hedgehog, and then the Sonic Advance series, and then Sonic Adventure series. That was my favorite. Another Jeffrey asked, well, my question is, what's the best sensitivity and stats on your 96 deco? And I can tell you that my best sensitivity is probably at -1 to -2, I would say. I switch my sensitivity so often, so I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. But gear, stack some swing speed and defense up. Nathan and Ile asked, how old are you? And I am in fact 19 years old. I turned 20 this year, or actually next month, March the 7th. Get me something nice, you know. I've told you the date, March the 7th. That's my birthday. I'll be 20. And yeah. Hank from Nintendo asked, how can I improve my chin game? Please answer. And you how to do this? You need to love and care for your chin. You need to, you need to spoil it. You also need to, you know, do some daily workouts with it, because you got to make sure your chin is strong, and you got to make that chin game on point. Sometimes what I do is, you know, I put like a weight in between my cleft, and you know, if you don't know what a cleft is, it's the, you know, the gap between your chin, and then I start nodding my head, and that's how you work out your chin. Yeah. Archer in the Woods asks, do you think competitive Splatoon will ever grow to the size of Smash or maybe even League? Yes or no? Explain. I do feel like this. I have faith in this. This is my little rant about it, if you want to know. Anyways, games like Smash and League, you know, Smash has been around for about 10, I don't even know how many years. This competitive Smash has been around for a while. And, you know, it wasn't always big. At the very start, there barely were any sorts of tournaments. But with over time, because the community was there, it grew it. The support of the community grew the game to what it is now. And they didn't give up on it. They wanted to show this game was competitive. Games like League, it's been around for... I don't even know how long League has been around for. But the thing is with League is that it's on PC. And a competitive PC like game like League, like Counter-Strike or anything like that, everybody has a PC. There's a load of people that have PCs. Like, pretty much everybody you would know has a PC. So, I said PC like 20 times in that sentence. But what I'm trying to say is that anybody could play League of Legends. They could get into it. It's so easy. That's why there's like so many people playing it. Like games like Counter-Strike as well. You can just you download the game for like £5, and League of Legends is free. So it's easy to get into. Why games like Splatoon, I should say, isn't as big as Smash and League? Well, first of all, Splatoon is new. Second of all, the Wii U did not sell as many consoles as it should have because the poor marketing and all that type of stuff. So that would mean that there aren't going to be as many people playing competitive Splatoon. But the thing is that so many people on the Wii U have bought Splatoon, it pretty much shows that, you know, this game, you know, it has the potential. I mean, the game competitively works. It's great for competitors. So I wouldn't say that this Splatoon will go big and competitive. Maybe in the future, like what Melee did. But if Splatoon 2, if there is a Splatoon 2, maybe on the Nintendo NX, if the Nintendo NX sells really well, maybe like, I don't know how many million consoles, if it sells really well, that means the next Splatoon game will sell really well, depending if it's good or not. Meaning the competitive scene will grow, the entire scene will grow. That's what I'm trying to say. So, I hope you guys enjoyed that explanation. Dusby asks, do I see myself playing Splatoon next year now that the updates are over? And honestly, yes, I do. Like, I have so much fun playing this game. Like, I'm not even bored of this game. I'll say one thing that doesn't get you bored of this game is literally just playing every single weapon. If you just don't do it like Smash, where you have to feel like that you have to only play one character to actually do good. Just use every weapon. You have so much more fun. Diamond Miner asks, do you find the final boss hard? And I didn't actually. So the Splatoon final boss, it wasn't actually hard. I mean, if you use sticks, you might have a little bit of problems, but motion controls, it was a walk in the park, I'll just say. It wasn't really hard, but it was really fun. It was probably one of the best, well, most well-designed bosses, like final bosses I've ever faced in like any type of game. JP7Games asks, what am I most hyped for 2016? I'll just say E3, pretty much every single gaming event, all the tournaments and all that type of stuff, playing in Japanese tournaments for Splatoon, and I don't actually know, you know? Like, I live life as, okay, I'm gonna do this today, and I'm gonna do this the next day, and then just, you know, just carry on like that. But, yeah. Kellative Chowdhury asked, how did I meet all my teammates from Paradise and Squidward Spades? And we pretty much all met up on Squidboards, and we pretty much saw each other on Twitch and all that type of stuff, and it kind of just went on from there. Literally, there wasn't too much backstory about it. Mabel Yachts asked, if there was a sequel for Splatoon, what stuff do you want to be included in the game? I actually have no idea. Like, if there was a second Splatoon game, I would want them to have the exact same formula of what they have in this game. You know, just use the same source. Don't change too many things. And I think Nintendo's smart about that. They don't change too many things. I mean, like, look at Mario Kart. They have, like, it's the same formula, except they add, like, a little feature, and everybody loves the game. I mean, if they just do that with Splatoon, I'll be happy. Adam Solomon asked, when will I do a face reveal? And I've already done this. My face has already been revealed. If you've watched my Sonic Lost World playthrough, or you just type it in your YouTube and go watch it, that's where you can see my face. It's no secret. I sometimes do it on stream as well. So he also asks, along with King Julian, what other games do I play other than Sonic and Splatoon? And I do play a lot of other Nintendo games. I do play a bit of Smash. I play a lot of stuff. I like to replay Star Fox games because for some reason I just never get bored of them. Like Star Fox Adventures, I can play that pretty much any time, and it's like the same story and the same things, and like I just know everything about it, and I always play that game. I don't even know why. As I said before, I am also playing Overwatch. I got into the beta, you know. Yeah, I did. And I do play a little bit of Call of Duty. Some very, very, very rarely. I don't play it too often anymore. I play it on PC, so. William Dawson asks, what do I think of the fan map? It's pretty interesting, you know, it's different. Like, you don't normally see, like, moving objects too much in Splatoon, so, you know, it's cool, I'd say. I'm still learning it. I don't really know how to play it on tower control. I'm a bit confused on it. I'm pretty sure, like, when you push it past about 60, you have to get a crack on in it so you can get it past the choke point, I guess. But, yeah. Stans the Skeleton said, I really appreciate the time you put into gaming. I watch you all the time. Keep it up. And P.S., what is your favorite sub-weapon? I don't actually have one. Like, there's no sub-weapon that I normally like using because I use so many different weapons. So, probably Disruptor because, like, there's literally no counter to it. So, I like Disruptors. Mr. Burger asked, did you think that your channel was going to grow this much and when you started making Splatoon videos? Also, did you plan on going into the competitive scene of Splatoon or did it just happen? Now, I did plan of, like, going into the competitive scene. Like, I really wanted this game to, like, be competitive. Like, I said that before the game even came out. So, yeah, this is... That's something that I really wanted to happen. And, it's happening. I mean, we're making it grow. If we just keep supporting the games competitively, you know, the scene will only grow. We just, you know, behave ourselves and all that type of stuff. And, yeah. And also, I didn't, of course, thought that my channel was going to get this big. I feel like my channel only got big because very kind people started posting my stuff on Reddit. I think I said this before earlier in the video, but... You know, very kind people started posting my stuff on Reddit. Literally, it was great. I thank for the people who did that. And Yorwe from Discord asks, want us to do a scrim sometimes? If not, a friendly 1v1? I promise I won't snipe myself. This guy. Anyways, Yorwe, you know, you sniped yourself. I've already won. It's cool. If you want to scrim, like, our team, then you might want to ask DJ about it. I don't really normally organize the scrims. Unless doing DJ's not here, then tell me. But, yeah. So, this video has been going on for 15 minutes now. So, I am going to cut it here. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I will be going on to answering the other questions. Because there's still a couple more questions I need to answer. I did say I was going to answer every single question. So, I am keeping my word to that. And I will... get to you guys as soon as possible. I'm probably going to be making the next video right after I finish this audio clip. Yeah. But anyways, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Please like, favorite, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Follow me on Twitter and Twitch, both in the description below. Do it for both if you're feeling generous, fast-talking me. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I shall see you guys in a future video.